Okay, so in the last class, we are looking at canonical ensemble, and then we looked at also other ensembles and what is the potential, depending on the potential which we want to minimize, how to calculate the partition function for those ensembles. So today we look at something called the grand canonical ensemble. And we'll use this to understand adsorption, monolayer and multilayer adsorption. And from there, I think we'll do a couple of problems either today or tomorrow. So this week we'll do some problems. Okay. So using my canonical ensemble, I showed that if I have an ideal gas, the chemical potential of an ideal gas, we calculated to be ln, where rho is the number density here. Remember, rho is n by v, number of molecules in a per unit volume, and this is equal to h square by 2 pi m kt to the power 1/2. Okay. So now if I just write this, I can write this as mu is kt log this plus kt log rho. So remember this, we, for an ideal gas, we write this is, so this is the basis of how that equation comes. Okay. So remember here we have written number density rho, which is for, since I'm dealing with particles, it's number density. For microscopic systems, this can be either partial pressures or can be the mole fraction, right? So you remember, so, okay. And now let's look at an ensemble. So we have looked at till now NVT, we looked at maybe NHT, right? And we have also looked at NVE. Now let's look at a problem of adsorption. So the idea is very simple. So have a surface. And this surface contains sites on which there is adsorption. So these kind of modeling techniques even also becomes very useful if you are looking at adsorption from statistical mechanics perspective. Okay. So now what are the conditions? I say is my surface has, and let's say all these points are, I'm saying those are the adsorption sites. Okay. And I have a gas here flowing through. So let's say gas at some pressure. So this is external gas that is flowing through. So what do we generally do in terms of when we look at adsorption macroscopically? So what we do is we vary the gas pressure and then we calculate what is the amount of. So I can either do something like this, right? So I vary the gas pressure. So here I calculate what is the fraction of my, or what is the mass, you can either say, right? This is simple, I am writing. What is the mass of the species that is deposited on the surface at the each given pressure maybe, right? And we do the experiments. The other way is also to, what is the fraction of species that is deposited? So if all the sites are occupied, then the fraction is 1. If none of the sites are occupied, the fraction is 0. So generally, this is how we carry out adsorption experiments. So there are different kind of adsorption isotherms, right? So I have Langmuir isotherm, I have Friedlich isotherm, then I have BET. So for now, what are we assuming from statistical mechanics perspective is that what is the best ensemble to solve this? So that begs a question that what is happening in this process? So are we keeping the temperature constant? So let's assume it's Fizi's option. There is not much of a evolution of heat during the reaction. So it's not an exothermic or endothermic reaction. So I have the inlet gas at some temperature and pressure, right? So my temperature I can assume is kept constant. And then my pressure of inlet gas, that is also kept constant. And the number of sides on the surface, right? So that is equivalent to here, since it's a 2D, adsorption is in 2D, it's similar to area, but you can also think of it as a volume. So the volume of the adsorbent, that's also is kept constant. So this volume or the number of sides on the surface is constant, right? Okay. So now looking at this, you might think that, I need to use somewhere temperature is constant, pressure is constant, and maybe volume is constant. So you can say that maybe TPV, right? Is this a possible ensemble? Can somebody tell me?
No, sir.
Why?
Sir, minimum one extensive variable should be there. Moreover, Gibbs Duham equation.
Yeah. So T is intensive or extensive?
T is intensive, sir.
P?
P is also intensive.
V?
B is extensive, sir, I guess.
Yeah, so there is an extensive variable.
So maybe Gibbs Duham equation, it's valid.
Yeah, so I can choose this, right? All three are not extensive. All three are not intensive. Right?
Sir, so can we have P and V together?
That is one, correct. So I have P and V are conjugate.
So they cannot be together, no?
They cannot be together.
So remember what is happening is that here if I just look at V, for I'm keeping V constant means you can say that, okay, let me say, the number of sides on the surface is constant. So this pressure and this volume are not the same. So remember that. So here when I say PV, T is the temperature. I'm only looking at this particular. In the normal case, what you told is correct. That's true. So the pressure exerted here is by the pressure exerted by the molecules, right, which are adsorbed on the surface. And then temperature is constant. Volume means the number of surface lattice sites. Okay. For now, think of it in that way. Okay. So this P and V are not directly. So even if I change P, V won't change here. Okay. Even if I had not kept V constant, V will not change. Remember.
So sir, here P and V are independent from each other.
Yeah. Yeah. Meaning to say that here we are only looking at the surface. Okay.
Yes.
So, but there is some confusion right here. So what I'm keeping P constant. So if I keep T and P constant, so at equilibrium, there is some fraction of what is changing on the surface. So the number of adsorbed molecules. That's changing, right? That changes. So there is a mean adsorption, but if I look at the, so this N number will vary, right? So this is the, I'm calculating N as a function of time. So this will vary around the mean position, but I'm not keeping n fixed. I'm only keeping m is the, you can think m is the number of sides. N is the number of adsorbed atoms. Okay, so I'm keeping m fixed, but n can change. So this is something new. So till now we were all looking at ensembles. If you look at this, n is changing, n was kept constant, nve, nvt, nht, right? So here we have a new ensemble where n is changing. So n, if n changes, what will be kept constant? What is the conjugate of n?
Mu.
Yeah, right. So at equilibrium, right, at equilibrium, the chemical potential of the gas is equal to the chemical potential of the molecules adsorbed. Right. So the chemical potential decides what is the quantity that would be adsorbed on the surface. Correct. Of course, temperature and pressure also there. And if I specify T and P, that means I am also fixing mu. Remember that. Right. So if I specify T and P, that means I'm fixing mu. Or if I specify T and mu, that means I'm fixing T. So remember Gibbs Duhem. So generally, since my N is varying here, so it's, instead of considering P, this does not kind of suit our purpose here, right? If I use TPV, because N is changing, I don't have a complex conjugate of that, which is kept constant. So what we do is we keep mu constant and T constant. And of course, V is also kept constant. So this is called the grand canonical ensemble, where mu, V and T are kept constant.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, after this, this mu gas external is equal to mu molecules absorbed. Sir, what did you say? Can you please repeat?
So,
yeah. Regarding this fixing mu and T mu.
Yeah. So basically, I have the mu at equilibrium, the chemical potential of the gas molecules should be equal to the chemical potentials of the molecules that are adsorbed on the surface. Correct. So by Gibbs Duhem, I know that I cannot keep both N, P and mu constant. T, P and mu constant. I cannot do this because this violates Gibbs Duhem. Right? So now I know that generally when you actually do these experiments, what is it that you are tracking? You track at what pressure, or what is the partial pressure of your gas, right? Gas molecules that is coming in. You don't measure the chemical potential, but you know how to, once you know the pressure, if you assume ideal gas, once you know the pressure, you know how to get the density. Once I know the density, I know how to get the chemical potential, right? That's what we derived in the previous, even today when we first started, we first looked at that. So what I am seeing is, for this ensemble, since N is changing, N is the number of molecules that are adsorbed on the surface. So remember, again, everything depends on what you choose as a system. So here I have chosen this, my surface, as the system surface with the molecules that are on it. All this are part of my system. So if I look at the system, what is at equilibrium? Mu is constant. At equilibrium, the temperature is constant. At equilibrium, volume is the amount of the volume of my system, that is constant. So by fixing, so a mu vt ensemble is ideal to solve this. And by fixing mu and t, it also means that you are fixing p. Remember that. So if a pressure, if I specify the pressure and temperature of the inlet gas, that means I also specifying what is the chemical potential of this. Okay. Or if I specify just the chemical potential in the temperature of the inlet gas, that means I am also telling you at what pressure I am pumping in the gas. Okay. So for, yeah.
The volume you are saying that constant. So it is a volume of total site available or the vacant site available or the absorbed site?
No, this is the volume of the surface. So you can think of the total sites on the surface, not the vacant sites, right? So this is, you think of a surface on which adsorption will take place and you measure and you put a boundary across that. And also maybe include also the size of the atoms, right, on which it things will adsorb. So if I just look at that, if I just look at my this particular, so this is my system. No matter what happens, my system volume will not change. That means the number of sites available on the surface for adsorption, not the vacant sites. The total number of sites are kept constant. That's what it means. Okay. Any questions? So that's why I'm letting the number of molecules that can adsorb vary. That will change. Okay. So now I look at this system. I have mu Vt. What is the potential? That is the first thing you need to. The potential W, what is it for this system? T is constant, mu is constant, V is constant. What is the potential? Somebody can tell.
So E minus T is.
Okay. Minus if I do minus?
Mu N.
Mu N. Correct, right? So if I do DW, what do I get? I get minus SDT. Minus N D mu. And here, since the variation in volume is there's no need because it's a solid surface, you can even neglect this. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, till now the systems which we have considered, whatever properties we took were of the same. Like if we took of the gas molecules, the N, V, E, everything was of the gas molecules only.
Yeah.
So for this system, the potential which we are defining, the volume is of the site of the solid surface, while the temperature is of the gas molecule.
No, the temperature pressure is also of the and the temperature chemical potential is also of the surface only, right?
Of the surface itself.
Yeah.
Sir, how will the surface have like chemical potential or temperature?
No, what if I. So if I have a surface, it will have a temperature, right?
Hmm.
So where is the adsorption occurring? Adsorption happens in a chamber. So the temperature of the chamber will be equal to the temperature of the your surface, right? And then if I look at the chemical potential, the chemical, of course, the molecules adsorbed on the surface, they are interacting with the surface. So there is some chemical potential associated with it. And at equilibrium, if you measure that chemical potential, that will be equal to the chemical potential of the external gas.
Okay.
So you have a surface, you equilibrate it to the temperature and chemical potential
of the gas molecule.
Exactly. That's it.
Okay.
So remember, for this, the ensemble is we call mu Vt, where mu volume temperature it's kept constant. So specifically for this, if I have to write, I can write this as also mu mt, where m is the number of sites, total number of sites. So when we actually specifically may externally use mu vt is, you can think of, let's say I have a gas. Anyways, I won't confuse you because there I would use NPT. But remember that if NPT also means your, if I'm fixing P and T, you are also fixing mu. Remember that. Okay, whenever there is a change in pressure volume variations, then I choose NPT. Whenever there is a number variation, then I choose mu VT. Okay, remember all these ensembles are same. Depending on the type of system you are looking at, I want to use that. See, for this ensemble, if I choose NVT, then it is very difficult to analyze the system. Then what should I consider as the system? I should consider my external gas and also the surface. So how does an experiment occur? So let's say I have a chamber. This is my surface. And let's say all this is inside a chamber. Okay. Now if I consider this entire thing as my surface, as my system. So let's assume I'll say this is my right. Now I can actually look at this system as what? Now this becomes because since this is my system, only the molecules are changing on the adsorbed the surface adsorbit. So, but if I consider the entire chamber, N is constant, V is also constant, nothing is changing, and T is also constant. So I can use NVT to study this. But what am I mostly interested? I'm interested to know what is the fraction of molecules that are adsorbing on the surface, right? So I'm mostly interested only on this. And if I keep N constant, there is nothing I can actually, nothing interesting, right? I want to actually know what is the fraction of molecules that have occupied the sites. And if I don't let this N fluctuate, then there is no point actually, you're not actually addressing the right question. Therefore, I use an ensemble where N can vary. So since N varies, mu will be kept constant because you're pumping in gas at a certain chemical potential. And your mu is kept constant, and so is T and the number of sites on the surface. So that's why, remember, I'm not writing this minus PdV here because it doesn't make sense. It has no, the variation in V with respect to P for the type of solid substrate we are looking at is not relevant. And similarly, even if I had a liquid, the same thing. Okay. Okay, so all doubts cleared?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, so now I have dW, which is the potential I want to minimize, is minus SdT minus ND mu. Now, what is the first thing is to write the partition function. So what is the partition function for this? So I'll say Z of mu T. I'm not writing V specifically, it's fine, right? So what is it? It becomes sigma. Remember, this becomes e to the power minus beta e minus mu n. And this over all EIs and all NIs. Remember, EI minus mu ni. Which are the things which can change? They have written as EI. And this is a microstate representation. Remember that. What I'm basically saying by writing this is sum over all microstates e to the power minus Hamiltonian of that minus don't get confused, this mu is the chemical potential and this the number in the microstate. That is what this means. Okay, and now why do we have this E term? Because when molecules adsorb on a surface, there's some interaction, right? So these can be, if it's you can think of it in such a way that if it's physics option, mostly I have some van der Waals interactions. Right, so I have van der Waals interaction, and let's say that I have this surface which has M lattice sites, and whenever a molecule adsorbs, there is a decrease in energy of, or we'll say the energy is epsilon 1. Generally, the epsilon 1 will be negative, meaning to say that it's favorable. But let's not worry about the sign. We'll say that energy is epsilon 1. Understand? So I have molecules, when it absorbs on the surface, there is a energy of adsorption, which is epsilon 1. Okay. So now how do I solve this? So this is the microstate. So from where I will say I'll come to density of state. So I'll say omega of E comma N e to the power minus. And if I assume that N molecules are, for any state, if N molecules are adsorbed, what is the energy of adsorption? This will be e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 times N, and then times e to the power, the minus minus becomes plus, mu times N. And this is a function of, remember, over all N's. Okay. And omega E is again, E is again a function of N. So I can just write this as omega of N, right? If N changes, it also means E will change. Everybody is following this. This is the number of molecules that can be adsorbed. E to the power minus beta epsilon 1 N times E to the power beta mu N. Is everybody following? If you're not, stop me at any point, okay? So I have this. Now, what is omega N? Omega N is nothing but the number of ways in which I can arrange this N atoms on the surface. So remember, this N can go from 0 to, what is the limit for N? And we are assuming, what are some assumptions we are making? One is, it's a monolayer adsorption. That means once one site is occupied by one molecule, that site cannot be occupied. Okay. The second is, there is no interactions between the molecules. Okay. So with these assumption, what are the total number of sites available? There are M sites. So yes, somebody has it.
So there are M sites and N molecule has to be observed. So it can be absorbing M, C, N ways.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Any other doubts? Okay. So I have M sites. There are N molecules that can absorb. And remember, this N is not fixed. Remember that. So that's why sigma is going over. N is 0 up to, it can go up to M. Okay, so this becomes M factorial, M minus N factorial times N factorial, right? So I'll look at this. M minus N factorial times N factorial. Here, what I'll do is, let's say e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 minus mu to the power N. Now for a binomial, I just also want the M minus 1 term, M minus N term. So it's just multiply by 1 to the power M minus N. So now I have it in a binomial form. This becomes nothing but 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 minus mu to the power N. Okay, so remember, the power is to the power M. Okay, is everybody following this? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So don't get confused with M and N, okay? So here, N is just something which can vary. So the partition function becomes this.
M is the maximum number of particle adsorbed, right?
Yeah, you can say that, but M is the total number of sites that can be, but that is also equal to the maximum number of particles that can adsorb.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so I have this. Once I have this, I know my W free energy is nothing but for this part is KT log Z. So this becomes minus MKT log 1 plus e to the power minus beta mu minus epsilon 1 minus mu. Okay, is everybody following this? Okay, so now I just want to calculate what is the fraction adsorbed, or I'm interested in N, right? So I know dW is minus SdT minus ND mu. So what is N? And remember, this is my classical thermodynamics or macroscopic thermodynamics. This N is nothing but the average N. Is minus partial dW by partial mu when I keep T constant, T and M constant. Okay, so if I just solve this, this is nothing but, if I look at this equation, this is minimal KT differential of ln 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon minus mu divided by d mu. Okay, so I just have to solve this. If I solve this, I'll get an equation. Sorry, there is m here. So this becomes m e to the power minus beta epsilon minus mu divided by 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon minus mu, or you can say epsilon 1 since I've used epsilon 1 everywhere. Okay, so this is the number of molecules that is adsorbed. So if somebody asks you what is the fraction that is adsorbed, the fraction that is adsorbed is n by m. So okay, so this is a general equation for adsorption of any gas, or even if you look at in terms of adsorption of gas on a solid substrate. Now if I make an assumption that the gas that is adsorbing is an ideal gas, if I assume that, so then I know my mu is KT log omega cubed, right? So my e to the power or my beta mu will become just ln omega cube p. So now e to the power beta mu will be this triangle cube times rho. Okay, all this we have studied. So if I just substitute that for an ideal gas, I get okay. So this is, if you look at what happens, okay, so let's assume when rho is very, very high. Rho is very high means my chemical potential also is very high. So I can say rho is, so that is equivalent to very high pressure.
Sir, rho is high means n over v, that is n is very high.
Yeah, n is very high means pressure is very high. So remember this, this rho is not the density of molecules on the surface. Don't get confused with that. This rho is how you are fixing the chemical potential. So this is the rho density of the inlet gas. Okay. So this has nothing to do with the n. This n and this rho are completely independent. This rho is for the external environment which you are keeping fixed. Okay. So if rho is very larger than one, so that means it's very high pressure. So then I can actually neglect the one term here. So n by m tends to one, correct, right? So if you look at very high pressures, all that means all the molecules are occupied. And if rho is very less than one, so then it goes as the first order equation. So I can neglect this term, but I'll have so it goes something like this. So this is typical of how a Langmuir adsorption is. So at moderate pressures, it goes as kind of first order, and then it goes as zero order. So this is when all the lattice sites are occupied, no matter how much you change the pressure. So this I can say maybe n by m. And here I'll say this is my pressure or mu. Or I can say chemical potential, because they are all dependent at constant T. Okay. So any questions? So even if I just look at this equation, let's assume if it's not ideal gas or any gas, what do I have? I have n by mu, n by m is e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 minus mu by 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 minus mu. Let's look at a range where T is tending to infinity. When if T goes to zero, beta goes to if T goes to infinity, beta goes to zero. So what do I have here?
No sites will be occupied.
Huh?
No sites will be occupied then.
No, half. 1/2.
1/2.
1/2, sorry. 1/2.
So this is e to the power beta goes to zero, right? As t approaches infinity, so I have 1/kT. T approaches zero, t approaches infinity, beta approaches zero. So e to the power zero. So this becomes 1/2. So again, what is this saying is if I just look at from the perspective of the surface, when will the, it will try to maximize entropy, and when will the entropy be maximum? When half the number of sites are occupied. So again, we are coming back to that, because in the limit as T approaches infinity, nothing will kind of govern. It's that is the only controlling factor. So it will always tries to maximize entropy. So let's look at the limit when T approaches zero. So beta approaches infinity. So minus beta approaches zero, correct? So let me just look at this. So let's actually write this as n by m. As t approaches zero, so this becomes beta approaches infinity. So e to the power minus infinity is, so what is the limit of, let's look at this, x by 1 by x limit as, what is x tending to here? What is x tending to here?
Zero.
X tends to 0?
Yes.
Zero, sir. X tends to zero.
Okay, let me just check. Beta infinity e to the power t approaches zero, beta approaches. So I'm getting a value of zero. Is that correct?
According to third law, it is correct.
What is it? If I just look at the system, when is the entropy will approach zero? That's what we say, right? According to third law, right? So if all the sites are adsorbed, then also my entropy will approach zero, right? How is it satisfying third law?
Not third law. I'm just saying that if temperature is zero and this n average of by m is equal to zero means entropy will be, means every atom will be none of the atom will be adsorbed, I think, at the temperature zero.
But is that correct? Because at low temperature, energy is the one which is helping. So if every atom is, if I can say, so it's not as simple to look at that limit, because if I look at this nm, I'll say e to the power, this becomes minus beta epsilon 1 times e to the power beta mu divided by 1 plus e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 power beta mu. Okay, so my t and mu are also in a way dependent, right? So then it depends on your chemical potential. Okay, so if my chemical potential is of the order of beta, or so my chemical potential is nothing but kBT ln, right? So my chemical potential becomes kBT ln. So what would be e to the power beta mu? So this will be, or beta mu is ln p, e to the power will be, and my omega, this triangle is also equal to h square by 2 pi m k t. So it is, I cannot just, even for the previous case, so let's look at this. So this is 1/2, right? So what will happen to this? As so I know, if I just look at what will happen to this at let's look at the limit first as t approaches infinity. At 3 approaches infinity, what will happen? This will go to, what will happen to the
zero,
right? This goes to zero, n by m tends to zero. So now which makes sense to you, this one or the one which where I said n over m is 1/2, which makes more sense? At very high temperature, what will happen to a molecule when it adsorbs? What will happen to its entropy? Does it increase or decrease?
It is increased.
Who is this?
Amit.
Amit, okay. So when a molecule adsorbs on a surface, the entropy of the molecule will increase?
Yes.
How? I have gas molecules, they are freely kind of, they have all these translational degrees of freedom, they are moving, and now as soon as I adsorb, my position is fixed. So what happened to the entropy? How can it increase?
It should decrease.
Entropy should decrease, right? So this, don't forget these things and get confused with the when you think of statistical mechanics, right? So now let's look at this. What we did previously was we neglected the mu is also a function of t. Remember that. So now if we write this in this way, I'll get n by m e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 e to the power beta mu is nothing but, let's write this way, okay. Now as t tends to infinity, okay, this tends to 0, and e to the power minus beta epsilon tends to, so t tends to beta tends to 0, though this tends to 1, so my n by m tends to 0. Okay, so here when you look at entropy, you should look from the perspective of the molecules. Okay, so just on the surface, yes, if there are more sides, the omega will increase, that is fine. But will the molecules even come and adsorb on the surface? Because if they adsorb, the entropy will decrease. On the surface, yes, you can, if only half of them are adsorbed, then the entropy will be increased. But from the gas perspective, at very high temperature, you can think of it that the adsorption is, what happens? Generally, physics option, what happens at high temperatures? It goes down, right? Remember. And high pressures, it will increase, but at high temperatures, it will go down. So this is again assuming there is no heat of reaction, etc., etc. Okay. So now let's look at the same as T tends to zero. As T tends to zero, I have h square, so I have omega cubed, so this controls, right? So this tends to infinity, so, and I can neglect this one, so in the limit as t tends to zero, n by m will approach one. Okay, because as t tends to zero, this tends to infinity, so I can actually neglect this one, so this just becomes omega cube rho by e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 by this gets cancelled, this becomes 1. So now this makes more sense, right? So at very high temperature, that there's no adsorption. At extremely low temperatures, all the molecules will be adsorbed because energetically they would have gained. If there are n molecules or m molecules adsorbed, what would be the total energy? It would be m times epsilon 1. Okay, so any doubts again? Can you ask?
Sir, can you repeat
the
last
portion,
sir?
Okay. Any other questions? I'll repeat that, but any other questions?
Sir.
Sir. Yeah. Yes.
Sir, I like this. This relation actually was from ideal gas, but considering that it is according to physics option. Can we generalize for every real gas also?
Yeah, yeah. Because real gas chemical potential will be similar to the ideal gas, but only the ln rho portion will change, right? So if I write, so it will be kT ln. So only this. So there will be some addition or deletion, right? So. But the overall will again be the same.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. But think of it from a physical perspective that at very high temperature, why would any molecule go and sit on the surface, right? Because even if it's sits, the temperature is so high that it will be dissolved at extremely high temperature. Think of it, right? And at very, very low temperatures, all the molecules want to come and sit on the surface, because anyways, entropy is not the driving force. So, but when I adsorb, I get some energy, a favorable energy of interaction epsilon one. So as a result, all the molecules will come and adsorb on the surface. So again, looking at this, my N by M expression is e to the power minus beta epsilon 1 by 1 plus, right? So in that limit as t tends to 0, omega cube tends to infinity. So this 1 becomes a very small number. So this just becomes 1 in the limit. Now as t tends to infinity, omega cube tends to 0. So the whole expression just becomes n by m will tend to 0. Okay. Any other question?
Sir. Yes. Sir, here when we are writing our omega, we are actually not considering the like the entropy of the gas, right? We are only considering the entropy of the our solid.
No. This.
So.
Yeah. Sorry. Go ahead.
Sir, so how can we tell that when T tends to infinity, like how can we bring the entropy of the gas inside our system, like if our system is only the solid?
Okay, that's a good question. Yes, any other questions? So, did everybody understand the question? So, the question is that I'm only considering this as my system, so I should only look at entropy of the system in terms of just the molecules. Is that the question? So did everybody understand the question? So now when I'm saying entropy of adsorption, I'm looking at if a molecule from the bulk comes and sits on the surface, then I'm saying the entropy will be lost. So none of the molecules will sit. But the question is that why should I even worry about this, right? I'm saying my system is this, so why should I look at that? So and some we are when we also looked at this equation n by m, we said, let me just write this again, beta mu e to the power minus beta epsilon by 1 plus e to the power beta mu. So now if I don't worry about this, for example, let me just write it as e to the power beta epsilon let me just fix that as let for example let let's forget about this I'll get something then e to the power beta mu plus 1 to the power, okay, if I forget this. Forgetting this. Okay, this is not correct, but this is not the correct expression. But forgetting that, I'll get. So now here, let me look at this as T approaches infinity. So beta approaches 0. So 1 over e to the power beta mu, which is nothing but this, will approach 1. Correct. So now here n by m will approach half, and this is nothing but, remember we did the, this is not nothing but a canonical distribution. If you look at your two state system, so this is nothing but that. Okay, so but now we have this thing which is e to the power beta mu, and if I make temperature tending to infinity, then this expression will also tend to infinity. So this is not independent. So that means if I am changing the temperature, the mu is also I am changing. So at that mu, I cannot have a system where half of them are occupied. Okay. So I will again discuss, this is a very good question you have raised. I'll again discuss this in detail. So, and also I'll post this video so you can look at it, and we'll again discuss this extensively, I think, tomorrow. Okay.